Hello,
Hello,
everybody.
everybody.
Welcome to Let's Talk For Real.
Yes.
Let's talk for real.
Hey.
So we know we didn't get a chance to pre-post we normally do. About when we're getting ready to come on, but I'm pretty sure you guys are used to the routine. So, thank you, Tanya.
Yes.
Hey, Nell. Thank
Hi,
y'all for
ladies.
Joining us on today.
Yes.
Hey, Catherine. I miss you. Yes, we're going to get started on Let's Talk For Real.
Yes.
We want to talk about Secret Soul Ties Part 2.
Say that.
And if you didn't get a chance to join us on last week, you can always go back on the Let's Talk For Real page and catch up with everything that we have been talking about. And we're just excited about what God is doing in this season. Hey, Tony. Long time no see. So we want to talk about, like we said, secret soul ties. I'm tongue tied. Secret Soul Ties Part 2.
Yes.
So we're going to get our sister to read over the definitions for some of you guys who weren't with us on last week, so you can play catch up a little bit, and we're going to get started.
Yes. Hey, Anita. Glad you joined us, lady. All right. So I am going to read the definition of soul ties, an unhealthy soul tie. Mm-hmm. Unhealthy soul ties are often the ramifications of having partners that you create a lifelong bond with through a sexual encounter or sexual encounters, mm-hmm. plural, but with whom you only have a short-term relationship with.
Mm-hmm.
The bond, which is also called the soul tie, remains long after the relationship
yes.
is over, leaving both sexual partners longing for wholeness.
Yes. And I gave a little bit of my backdrop and my backstory on last week. I was talking about a situation where I was in a emotional soul tie. It was a person that I had been was friends with for years, and I had went through some emotional and some traumatic things in my marriage, and that person became my place where I like to stay. I can lay my head and to be vulnerable about some things that I was going through. And some of the feedback that I got on last week was basically, why do tell that? You know, why did you disclose that information, and what did your husband think about you sharing what was going on in your marriage? And I said, you know, the thing for me is the thing that keeps us in bondage is the secret things. It's the secret things that are killing us in our marriages.
That's right.
In our relationships, in our friendships. It's the things that we don't want to tell anybody else about, because the
right.
word of God tells us that we overcome by the words of our testimony.
Yes.
And we can't give our testimony if we're always hiding in these secret places and dealing with these secret relationships. Therefore, that's why we coined this secret soul ties, because those
yes.
are the things that are really killing relationships.
Yes.
And so I wanted to be transparent and let you guys know that we're just not sitting up here talking about different topics and talking about stuff that we haven't experienced, because I think experience is a good teacher. It gives mm-hmm. us a good life lesson. And if we're not willing to share that with other people, then we're not being, like we said, we're not talking for real.
Right.
And so I said, you know, and I'm able to talk about it because I'm delivered from it, and deliverance will let you be free to talk about your situations and what's going on with you, because it's really not about me, it's about somebody else. And so that was the reason why I shared what I shared. And I don't think nobody else can tell your story like you can tell your story.
No,
they can add to it.
That's
they
right.
can put other little situations with it, but at the end of the day, can't nobody speak my truth but me.
That's right.
So that was some of the feedback that I got. And did you want to jump in?
Yeah, so before I jump in, I just want to acknowledge a couple of people that just tuned in with us. My oldest sister, Daisy.
Hey Daisy. Sis.
How you doing? I see Miss Margaret McPhail joined us. Hey, lady. My nephew, Nicasio, joined us as well.
And
so thank
Tamika.
You guys for tuning in.
Tamika and Thurman.
Hi, Tamika and Thurman.
And
is that Natasha? Hey, guys. Thank you guys for tuning
in
today.
And hey, Ms. McDowell.
So today, hey. So all of those who are tuning in, we really do appreciate it. I think my sister has already shared our video, so we appreciate you sharing our video already, sis. So thank you so much. So when we're talking about secret soul ties, it was so many things last week that was in my spirit that I wanted to talk about. And one of the things was, I remember a young lady telling me that she developed a relationship with a young man on her job.
Yes.
And the young man was in the process of getting married. He had just gotten engaged. And she began to have a sexual relationship with this guy. And so what happened was, of course, the young man got married. And because she had entered into a sexual relationship with the young man, of course, there was some emotional strain that happened when he got married. And as a result of that, he still wanted to have a sexual relationship with her, meaning he wanted to have his cake
and
eat it too. Now, and the reason why I'm sharing this is because this young lady is not the only young lady who have entered into a secret relationship on her job. Because one thing I do know for sure, because I've done it, when you are involved with someone on your job and the relationship goes sour, it is really hard to continue to work alongside that person when you have to see them every day. And not only that, sometimes people are vindictive and they will begin to do things just because they know that they're going to be seeing you every day, Monday through Friday. So they begin to do things that will probably try to get under your skin. And that's exactly what happened in this situation. So what am I saying to you today? I'm saying to you that when you're talking about a soul tie, please don't get involved with somebody on your job. And the other thing is, this is the thing about this particular person. She did it one time. But then guess what?
She did it again.
She did it what?
She did it again.
She did it what?
She did it again.
She did it again.
Because she had opened herself up for that.
Say that.
Because she had opened herself up for that.
And when you open yourself up for that, you're going to continue to get what you always get. You're not going to get anything different until you change your mindset, until you make up in your mind that I am better than this. Who am I talking to today? I'm talking to me because I was that person. And I, when I came to the realization that I'm better than that, then things began to change. And I knew right then from that moment moving forward, never again. And I know they say never, but let me tell you something. I never entered into another relationship with somebody that I work with.
And we also got to be careful about these work relationships that we have. We know we coined them our work husbands and our work wives.
I've heard that term before.
And it starts out as an innocent situation like that because you get along. They say most of the time you're at work the bulk of your day and you're spending it with your coworkers, so they become your extended family. So with them becoming your extended family, you also take on the dynamics of the family at work. So I know I've had my work husband, and I know I've been called a work wife, and that person makes sure that when you're at work, they're taking care of you. They're making sure you got your lunch. They're making sure that they're complimenting you. They making sure that they doing all of that. So don't get tricked by thinking just because you're playing the role of a work husband and a work wife, that's how it starts. That's how you open yourself up, like she was saying. It starts with Communication. You're talking to that person about what's going on with your spouse and what's going on in your house and what's going on with your job, because you're with that person all the time. Think about people who are on their jobs where they're working 12-hour shifts
or
14 to 16 hours a day. So that means that the bulk of the time you're with that person, and that person, you know, you confide in them and you're dealing with them on a regular basis, and now you find yourself really playing that role like that person is more your spouse than your spouse at home.
Exactly.
You're communicating with them more.
Yes.
You're hanging out with them more.
Yes.
And then you find yourself in a sticky situation, because now you don't just pick a work wife or work husband that you're not attracted to.
Right.
Come on, let's not even play that game.
Right.
We said we're talking for real.
That's right.
So my work husband, when I worked at a different location, not where I am now, but he was the typical guy. He was the typical type that I liked back then. And so, you know, we hooked up together. That's my work husband. That's my work wife.
Yes.
But at the end of the day, we still had a friendship where we didn't cross the line, but it could have been crossed.
Yes.
And so you got to be careful with even those type of relationships.
You do have to be careful with those type of relationships. And this is another thing.
Mm-hmm.
So I was listening to a conversation. I was really involved in a conversation. And the young lady said, remember last week we talked about how people, like I'm the wife. I gave y'all the example of me being the wife, and then the young lady befriends me.
Right.
And she befriends me, and I start sharing intimate things about my marriage with this person, not knowing that this person is liking my husband, and we are in a mutual setting with other people, and this young lady starts liking my husband, and me not knowing that I'm constantly giving her intimate details about my relationship, and then come to find out she and my husband start having a secret affair. So as we were talking about that scenario, this scenario came up.
Yes.
That the young lady started talking, say for instance, same scenario, the young lady starts talking to me about her man.
Giving them secrets, giving them ammo.
And not only that, but to find out that her man is my husband.
Well, you need to say that again just in case they missed
I said that the young lady befriends me and starts talking to me about her man. She starts talking to me about her man, only to find out that her man is my
her husband. Yeah, it's talking about secret soul ties and some stuff getting toe up right about then.
Can you say that again?
Because you got some people who will purposely seek your friendship, like we talked about last week. They purposely seek out you as a friend because they got their eye on your mate, and they'll take what you're telling them in confidence, and they'll use it against you. Then now you're sitting up here in a situation where you're trying to figure out, well, how did she know this about him, and how did he know that about her? It's because you done been in that situation where you're talking to them now, giving them the inside scoop on how to scoop your man or scoop your woman. So we got to be careful about, you know, even with, like we said, about those secret inboxes and text messages and all those things that we're dealing with now, especially with social media. We got people who would dress up and make themselves whoever they want to be. I was laughing about everybody that knows me. No, I'm all things Idris Elba. I know that is my Mufasa. That is my man. And it was so funny that I had my Idris to inbox me on Facebook, send me something on Instagram, send me something on Twitter. And it's because some sick person out there would take on, you know, dealing with women, or not just women, but men, and posing to be that person.
Yeah.
And then I got to the point where I was like, how all three of these Idrises are talking about me and don't know they talking about me to me?
Yes.
So that was a red flag to me to let me know, wait a minute. And I even put up there and said, okay, how all of y'all are Ildris, but all of y'all don't know what y'all been talking about. So you got to be careful with people will pose and say they are who they're not because they're not secure in who they are, that they will create a whole nother identity. And they're doing it a lot with social media. And there are a lot of people who are so head over heels over these celebrities, people that they're not going to ever meet or ever have a situation with anyway. And they're finding themselves in secret relationships with people who are on social media. Look at Catfish. How people will be in a relationship 2 to 3 years on the internet.
Yes.
And then when they finally meet the person is nothing like what they said. And then they're all upset because now you done confided in them. You done gave money to them. You done did all this stuff for these people that they're not even who they say they are.
Exactly. So I want to go back to something too, sis, about women who are seeking out married men.
Mm-hmm.
And you become the girlfriend. Mm-hmm. You walking in the spirit of the girlfriend. This will be a great on-ramp into walking into the spirit of the girlfriend.
Mm-hmm.
And it is a secret soul tie as
it
well.
Is. Mm-hmm.
But you now are walking in the spirit of a girlfriend.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot I've heard women, because I know I used to be one of these women,
mm-hmm.
to say, I would prefer a married man than a single man. Because
mm-hmm.
we're talking for real today.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Because with the married man, I really don't have to do a lot in terms of commitment.
Mm-hmm.
But let me tell you something. Any woman that is listening to this broadcast or tuning into this broadcast today, and if you are in a relationship with a married man, can I tell you today mm-hmm. that you are fooling yourself if you think that that's all you want. That if you are fooling yourself, and I'm going to break it down to you in just a minute. I just want to make sure that I communicate to you that you are fooling yourself mm-hmm. if you think that that's really what you want. Because mm-hmm. let me tell you what happens.
Uh-huh.
Regardless of what you tell yourself in your mind,
mm-hmm.
every holiday, when every holiday rolls around,
mm-hmm.
you're going to want to be with him.
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm. When it's time for your birthday and you want to have a special time for your birthday and he can't be there, you're going to miss that.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
There are times when he has to go and fulfill his husband duties because it's their anniversary and you know their anniversary date. Y'all not going to talk
mm-hmm.
to me. Mm-hmm. You're going to have some type of mm-hmm. emotional breakdown.
Yes.
That's the best way to describe it. You're going to have an emotional breakdown because you understand that time that you're saying that, oh, you glad to be in a relationship with a married man, but mm-hmm. every woman wants attention.
Yes.
Every woman wants to know that she is number one.
Mm-hmm.
There was a song out there that she said, if I can't be number one, I will not be number
uh-huh.
two. But let me tell you something. There's so many women out there today, because
mm-hmm.
I used to be one of them
mm-hmm.
that settled for number two.
Mm-hmm.
And then this is the other thing. This is the clincher right here. Oh, sis, I know
uh-huh.
I'm talking right because I was that woman and
mm-hmm.
it happened to me. When he tells you that he is not sexually involved with his wife, I'm telling you, you can believe that lie if
mm-hmm.
you want to.
Lies.
Now, this is Let's Talk For Real. Now, you can believe that lie if
mm-hmm.
you want to. You fooling yourself.
Mm-hmm.
There is no way in the world
mm-hmm.
that a man that is married to a woman, I don't care how horrible he tells you she
mm-hmm.
is. This is one thing I would not allow this person that I was dealing with. I said, you can't talk to me about your wife.
Uh-huh.
I'm not going to let you do that.
Mm-hmm.
Because, see, I done been there and done that. And when you've been there and done that, you learn
uh-huh.
that the very thing that he's telling you that he is not doing,
he's doing.
Say it again.
He's doing.
And more.
And more.
And more.
Mm-hmm.
And so then here it is. You're riding around in a Pinto and he's bought her a Lexus
mm.
or a Jaguar or
mm.
a Bentley or a Benz.
Uh-huh.
And you riding around in a Pinto. And this is another thing. Oh, now, I feel my help coming.
Go ahead.
This is another thing. You sisters that are out here with these brothers and y'all are opening, the sister called it the Red Sea.
Partner, the Red Sea. Yeah.
Girl, I love it.
Mm-hmm.
You caught your Red Sea. And you think that your red sea is the only red sea that he is parting. Let me give you an extra read all about it. Honey, your red sea is not the only red sea. A red sea is just a red sea. A gold mine is just a gold mine. And a gold digger gonna dig in a gold mine as long as it's considered a gold mine. Mm-hmm. Y'all not gonna talk to us right there.
That's okay.
Okay? Am I talking
You're talking right.
Am I telling the truth?
Is she telling the truth? And I can say it from the flip side, because see, I was, what, you know, I shared some of mine on last week that my husband had an affair, and that woman was thinking that, you know, he was gonna stay there, that he was gonna leave, that he was gonna do that. And I said, honey, what made you think that your however long y'all were having that affair had any bearings on his 15 years with his wife? Did you not think that he was gonna go home? So what she did when she took her safety net away of, I'm going to tell your wife, I'm going to go to her job. I know where she take her child for daycare. I know where she work. I know where you live. But when she took that safety net away and he called me, and now it's out here in the open, she ain't got nothing else to stand on. Yeah.
Yeah, I know. And then these sisters that are out here that are departing your red seas, and you're having sex with this individual, and then you get up. This is a situation that happened in my family. My sister told me that one of my family members came to her and told her that she was hungry, but she had just told her that the night before she had stayed with her boyfriend. So... Secret soul ties. One is out in the open, though. This one isn't open now. But it's considered an unhealthy soul tie. Not secret, but unhealthy. So you mean to tell me that you are sleeping with somebody, giving all of yourself to this person, and you can't even get a meal?
Ooh, a meal? You can't even be seen out in public.
You can't. You can't even get anything to eat.
Yeah, you can't even get in the car, let alone leave the house.
You
and get something to eat. You what? Ain't even get your bill paid. So you was parting your red sea with no benefits.
The spirit of the girlfriend.
The spirit of the girlfriend.
Trying to act like she's
in the spirit of the wife.
Come on, talk about it. Talk about that. We talked about that earlier in one of the broadcasts, and I was saying that I was walking in the spirit of practicing divorce when I'm dating somebody and we break up. I get together with somebody else, we break up. I get together with somebody else, we break up. Then I get married. What happens? Because I've been practicing that spirit of divorce all those years. And so, yeah, go ahead.
Hey, you know, see why I'm so excited and I can laugh and talk about this thing again. And like I said, it's because I did not allow what happened to me to keep me in bondage. So for those that feel like, oh girl, you're crazy, why you do this and why you did that, and you got to understand, you can't walk my walk. You can't talk my talk. You can't do what I do, because what I'm birthed out and ordained for me to do is not meant for anybody else. Like I said, I can only talk about my situation and what happened for me.
Right.
And all I know is that when you're dealing with a secret soul tie, as long as that thing is secret, it's exciting. And long as you're sitting around and you're hiding and ducking and diving and doing all of that, that excitement is what keeps that affair going. That excitement is what keeps that soul tie there, because now you think you're doing something and you're getting away with it.
Yeah.
But you're really not getting away with it. But
no,
once the secret is out.
Yes.
And the damage has been done.
Yes.
And that's one thing I told that girl. I said, you know what? You don't have nothing else now. What else you got? I can do whatever I want to do with him. But you ain't got no more options.
And how does that leave her feeling?
Yeah, you don't have no more options. But I got choices on what I can do.
And you're on the beneficiary part. You're the beneficiary.
What? Girl.
Wives have benefits.
That's right, Tanya. Girlfriends playing the wrong position.
Yes, honey. Exactly right.
Mm-hmm.
And so many of us women, we get entangled and entrapped in that wrong position.
And it's just not women, too.
It's men
too. You got men that are out here putting themselves on hold and being the catcher.
Yes.
He's the pitch hitter.
Yeah.
So he coming in temporarily and hitting home runs.
Yeah.
But at the end of the day, he going to want something too. He going to want more than just you dropping by and you doing this and you doing that. He's going to want that. Everybody wants to, like she said, have that right position.
Yeah.
And after a while, you're going to have to make some choices when you're dealing with a secret situation. Secrets are not meant to stay secrets.
Oh, what does the Bible say? What's done in the dark gonna come to the light?
Always come to the light.
Always does.
It always come to the light. It's either gonna come to the light on its own, or there's gonna be some situations that happen that's gonna make it where, oh wow, this is what's been going on.
Yeah.
But it's coming out.
Because,
don't think you're getting away with anything.
Yeah, because I'm a firm believer that God will give us an opportunity to get it right.
Mm-hmm.
I'm a firm believer that mm-hmm. God will give us the opportunity to get it right. And then when we don't take that opportunity to get it right or make mm-hmm. it right, then he does what he needs to do.
Mm-hmm. And that's why I said that, I said on last week, don't get it mistaken and think that somebody else's husband
is your
soulmate. How's that possible? He's already got a mate. But you think that you're going to make a wife or make a husband your soulmate? We meant to be together. But don't you know your foundation is already cracked? How are you going to trust a situation where you already having an affair and you already sneaking around and creeping around? Then you're not going to trust that person because your foundation is wrong.
Right.
And because the foundation is wrong, you can't build on that. So when people leave spouses and go with the side piece and go with the side him or whoever, and you think that you're going to get with that person and that marriage is going to last and it's going to stand, no, you're going to always be looking at them side eye because you already know how you got that person. And I believe karma knows everybody edge.
Absolutely. And then talking about side piece, you know, there's a song
mm-hmm.
that some guy made talking about, will you be my side piece? Can you believe that they made a song that said, will you be my side piece?
And there's some people out here that will brag about being
a side piece.
They enjoy being the side piece. Because like she said, you're not dealing with the full person. You're dealing with that person part-time. So you don't get the benefit of seeing what they like 24/7. You get
right.
the good piece of them.
Right.
You
That's
get the
right.
piece where it's the honeymoon phase. You're
That's
not getting
right.
that joker when you're sitting up there looking at him like,
Exactly.
You ain't.
Right.
What?
Right.
You ain't seeing how he doing everything. You get
right.
that sunshine part of him,
mm-hmm.
the butterflies and all that stuff. You're
all
not getting the
lies.
Hard work
you getting
and the dirt
lies.
Up under the fingernails.
That you're the wife is already
yes,
putting
you're not
in.
Getting all of that.
Mm-hmm. And then what happens when...
mm-hmm.
Lord, maybe I better not say that.
Say it.
Let's talk for real. Maybe I better not say that.
Say it. Let's talk for real, honey. They ain't looking for no sugar coat. They looking for the truth.
Oh my God.
Somebody need it. Somebody out there sitting right now is a secret place. Somebody right here is a side piece. Somebody else right now is thinking that that person is going to leave that spouse to be with me. Somebody else is thinking that.
And why do they think that?
Mm.
Why do men and women think, the men that are in relationships with someone that's married, the women that are in relationships with someone that's married, why do they actually believe that they are going to leave their spouse?
Mm-hmm.
What is it in you that wants to capitalize on something that don't belong to you? We as women, when we are walking in that spirit of a girlfriend, have the nerve to get mad when he ups and marries somebody else. Why you gonna get mad when he up and marries somebody else when you have you yourself? Now you think you are really in the spirit of a girlfriend, but you have been in a false position as a wife because you've been doing things. Look,
now you don't prepare him for somebody else. So you don't put in all this work.
If you don't stop
you
taking the words
around.
Out my mouth, go ahead.
You done did all of this
go
work
ahead.
For somebody else to benefit from it. And then you surprise.
And get mad. And then you want to slash tires.
And bust out windows.
And burst out windows.
And put bleach on clothes.
And put, you know, go out in there. Then you want to get on Facebook and talk about this individual.
Wow.
But that was a choice you made.
Mm-hmm.
You made the choice to be the girlfriend in the wife position.
Now, we were also talking about on last week, so we don't want anybody to think we're bashing and thinking that the secret soul ties was just about relationships. We
right.
were also talking about secret soul ties with us as believers.
Yes.
And Christians and fire baptized, where we sitting up here still having secret soul ties with the devil.
That's right.
How we're still doing things that are pleasing our flesh.
That's
how
right.
How we still are tiptoeing around the back of God and
that's
doing
right.
things that we know is out of character, like Tanya said. We get all out of character.
That's
we're doing
right.
all,
we do.
So secret soul ties is just not about a physical relationship.
Right.
It's a spiritual relationship too. So we don't want you to think that we're just talking about, you know, men and women dealing with marriages and girlfriends and relationships like that. We're still talking about secret soul ties even when it comes to spiritual matters.
That's right.
Because there's a lot of us that are having affairs on God right now. There's
absolutely.
A lot of us that are putting out a sneaking behind the sheets and thinking that he don't see us parting the Red Sea with our legs wide open.
I'm trying
that
to
we
tell
don't think
you.
We think we're getting away with stuff and then getting back in the pulpit and getting in the choir stand and doing praise and worship, and we're doing all this stuff in the pews, but we still doing secret soul ties too. So don't we want to make sure that we're putting all this in here together.
Absolutely. And then even in the church, there are people who are not in leadership, who are having secret relationships with their pastors. And this is the kicker, though.
Mm-hmm.
And I want y'all to hear this, and this might go over some of y'all's heads, but the pastor don't even know that they're having a relationship with
Ooh,
them.
Girl.
That's what I said.
Yes.
I said the pastors don't even know that they're having relationships with them.
Woo! Lord,
but y'all,
I got it.
You got it.
I got it.
Okay, I hope some of you out there got it. I hope it didn't go over your head.
You know why it ain't go over? Some of them didn't get it because some of them is them. It's them.
And so when you talking about those spiritual secret soul ties, you know, you having a relationship with somebody, they don't even know you having a relationship with them, and they're your leader. But y'all don't want to hear about
taking
that.
Taking care of all of that and ain't even taking care of home. You treat him better than you treat your own spouse. You can get his food, but you can't get your husband food.
Won't even fix your husband a plate. Y'all, let's talk about that.
You can get dressed up for him, but you can't even get dressed up at home.
Come on.
You can give him a compliment and say amen all day long, but let your husband say something and you ready to tear him down.
Exactly. Secret soul
amen.
Ties. Amen, church. Come on, can we get an amen?
Ooh.
Amen, church. We talking about
and that's the difference between reverencing the man and woman of God and lusting after the man and woman of God. Because
yes.
that anointing is attractive.
It's attractive. I'm telling you, it is attractive.
It's very attractive.
Did that, done that. It is very attractive. It is very attractive.
It is.
The anointing attracts.
You'll follow that man everywhere he go.
Absolutely.
And then can't even follow your husband down the street to get to help him pick up the car because he done dropped it off for oil. Change.
Come
and
on,
you can't
here.
Even go get him because you got to get to the church.
Yes, because you in an unhealthy
and telling him to call Uber.
Secret soul tie. That is something. I'm telling you. So listen, we have to do better. I mean, I know we giggling and laughing, but Ooh. We are telling the truth.
Amen.
Richard joined us. Frida joined us. Damon joined us. Hi guys. Thanks for tuning in today. Good to see you. We're talking about secret soul ties.
And we talked about last week on what you need to do to disconnect yourself from secret soul ties. I was sharing with her today, I had a friend of mine that was telling me, you know, he newly divorced and went through a lot of things with his wife, and she wound up leaving the marriage, and he's devastated behind it to the point
right.
that he had to go and see a therapist about
yes.
it. And then seeing the therapist, he's brought all these items that he had of him and his wife. Well, she's moved on and gone on about her business, but right. he's still tied to the things. He's still tied to every time he look at a picture or he look at something that's going on. He even got a, mind what's that, a little shrine right. of all this stuff. That, right. And it's been a year. And so and when he went to the therapist was telling him, you know what you're suffering from? Mm. You're suffering from an unhealthy soul tie.
An unhealthy soul tie.
And he's like, what you got to do is you got to disconnect from it because that person has gone on with their life. Although you made a commitment to say to death do us part, that person said, no, I'm going to marry you until they don't. It's not convenient for me anymore. And because that person left, now this person is sitting up here still in bondage, still yes. tied to the things and yes. still don't know how he's going to function with life. And it's because it's an unhealthy soul tied. And so for a therapist to even know that that's what he's dealing with, and we out here don't even know that that's what we're dealing with. That's why when you hear certain songs, it right. reminds you of that person, or yes. you smell certain smells, it reminds you of that person,
yes.
or a certain season, or a certain time, or a certain movie, or all those things, because that person has deposited themselves in your spirit.
Yes.
That's what the soul tie is about. It's and so awful. Until you're able to really allow God to take that thing and dissect that thing out of your heart, you're going to continue to let those things be like, oh, remind you of, what's that song you remind me,
right?
Yeah, so you gotta gotta learn how to sever that tie. And we talked about what you needed to do on last week, so yeah. I don't know if you want to do a recap on that.
Yeah, want to make sure that you have to first of all, you got to pray, you got to have a conversation mm-hmm. with yourself, you have to sever all communication with the person.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you really have to sever all communication. And then you need to get in your word.
And you got to be willing to do it.
And you have to saturate mm-hmm. yourself with the word of God so that the word of God can heal you.
Mm-hmm.
It can cleanse you.
Mm-hmm.
It can strengthen you. It can purify you. That's the only way you're going to actually overcome this soul tie, because a soul tie is mm-hmm. strictly about your flesh.
That's it.
The soul mate is strictly spiritual.
Mm-hmm.
And that's a huge difference mm-hmm. between a soul tie and a soul mate.
A soul
tie is strictly about your flesh. It's about you gratifying your flesh. Mm-hmm. It's about you giving in to your flesh. Your flesh is in control.
Mm-hmm.
But when you're talking about a soul mate, your spirit is in control.
Yes.
It's all about everything spiritual. Because when you're dealing with a soul mate, that means that you are fulfilling purpose.
Yes.
You are walking out the purpose that God mm-hmm. has for your life. But when you continue to deal with a soul tie, you continue to draw yourself further and further and further mm-hmm. away from what God has called you to do.
Mm-hmm.
Because that very thing that has you entangled in bondage mm-hmm. now has become your God.
Mm-hmm.
That's why you go to bed with it. You mm. wake up with it. You brush your teeth with it. You sit down at the
yes.
dinner table with it. You talk about it. You be thinking about it when you're in your house,
yes.
when you're listening to music, when
mm-hmm.
you're driving down the street, when you're going to get groceries.
Mm-hmm.
That's why you're doing all of those things, because it's about gratifying your flesh
mm-hmm.
when you're dealing with a soul tie.
Yes.
So if you want to come out, then there are certain things that you have to be willing to do.
Yes.
And we said last week, getting rid and cutting yourself off from a soul tie, it is not easy.
No.
We get that.
Mm-hmm.
Been there.
Done that.
Got the t-shirt. Mm-hmm. Put it in a drawer. Took it out.
Yes.
Wore it again.
Bedazzled it.
Come on.
Yes.
Come on
mm-hmm.
here. Talk about that. So it's not an easy
yes.
thing, but you can do it.
Mm-hmm.
You can come out if you want to. And
yes.
I promise you, you'll be better for it.
Mm-hmm.
You'll be better for it.
Mm-hmm.
You will be better for it.
And then you'll allow yourself to, like she said, the healing process to take place, because sometimes we're spending so much time on that soul tie relationship
mm-hmm.
that God can't give us our soulmate experience, because we're still tying everything that we want somebody to be like that person, or we want somebody to treat me like that person treat me, or how that person makes me feel. But like she said, when you're dealing with that, then you're dealing with your flesh. flesh. Absolutely. But see, God don't give us what we want. He give us what we need.
Yes, that's right. There's Pastor Noel Sims. Hey, Pastor. Mm-hmm. He said, good word. Yes. Thanks, Pastor. Bless you. Bless you.
And that's the number one thing we fight about, because we want what we want.
Yes.
We don't want what God necessarily what would complete us and make us whole. And right. That's why so many of us out here that are broken and are dealing in these dysfunctional relationships, and we're dealing with, like she said, those unhealthy soul ties. Mm-hmm. It's because we're already broken. Mm-hmm. We don't know who we are. We're already dealing with an identity crisis ourselves, and now we're going to put somebody else in the mix of this thing, and then we're wondering why we can't get free.
Right, because we have a deficit in our capacity. Mm-hmm. Here it is. You want somebody to give you 100%, and they only have the capacity of 20%. Mm-hmm. So then when you're going into a relationship, you're entering into a relationship that has a deficit from the mm-hmm. onset. But we don't know this because we are broken.
Right.
It's two broken people trying to make a whole. That will never work. You need to make sure that you are whole going mm-hmm. into a relationship. And I will tell you, you walking in the spirit of a girlfriend, trying to fulfill the duties of a wife, you are at a deficit. Mm-hmm. There is some depletions mm-hmm. that has happened. There's a lot of more withdrawals mm-hmm. than deposits that have been made in you. Mm-hmm. And then the deposits that have been made in you mm-hmm. have been negative, to the point where it causes a depletion. Mm-hmm. It continues to cause depletion until you are absolutely bankrupt mm-hmm. emotionally. And when you become bankrupt emotionally, whether you are male or mm-hmm. female, you become numb. And mm-hmm. when you become numb, you don't care. And you mm-hmm. begin to do all manners of things, like Tanya said. You begin to act outside of mm-hmm. your character. Yes. Mm-hmm. And then you're wondering, what in the world is wrong with mm-hmm. me? But can we help you today?
Yes.
Lord have mercy. If you would do, if you won't do it for you, do it for your mama. Do it for your daddy. Do it for your sister if you have a sister. Do it for your brother. If you have children, do it for your children. Mm-hmm. Come out. I remember Diana Ross mm-hmm. had a song, and the more I think about the song, it is so prophetic.
Mm-hmm.
She says, I'm coming out. Mm-hmm. I want the world to know. I gotta let it show that I'm coming out.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what we are praying for you today, mm-hmm. to come out.
Mm-hmm. Because if you don't, what's going to happen? That's why we have generational curses. That's why we have, you know, certain spirits in our family that's operating. You have that spirit of adultery. You have the spirit of depression. You have all those things because it has a territorial right to keep doing what it's doing, because nobody has stood up and say, enough is enough.
It stops with me.
We don't understand. That's why we look at certain family dynamics and we see our uncle is sitting over there cheating on his wife, and then you wonder why his son cheating on his wife, and then you wonder why it's going on because it's a generational curse, and we have control over that we can stop that thing whenever we get ready.
We can stop it,
but like she said, we don't stop it. It's because we're dealing with ourselves in the flesh, and the flesh is feeding up, because I believe the thing that you feed the most is the thing that's going to grow the
absolutely.
Most.
Absolutely.
So if you're feeding your spirit man all the time, that's going to be the stronger force. If you're feeding your flesh all the time, that's what's going to dominate.
Yes. And so I know that we are like 10 minutes over our time. We normally mm-hmm. try to do a 30-minute broadcast. And so we don't want to keep you guys much longer. But we definitely want to surely mm-hmm. encourage you to come out.
Yeah.
Because soul ties, they will kill you.
Yeah,
they will kill your joy.
Yes.
They will kill your happiness.
Yes.
They will kill your peace. Mm-hmm. The Bible says that the enemy comes only but to kill, steal, and destroy.
Mm-hmm.
And I began to think about that passage of scripture. Mm-hmm. Isn't it interesting that he kills you first? Whatever kills your joy, kills your strength, whatever that is,
mm-hmm.
and then it's kill, steal,
mm-hmm.
and then destroy.
Mm. Girl, that's a whole nother thing right there.
I mean, we could really talk about that. That he comes to kill, steal, and destroy. Because in my mind, I always thought that if you kill something,
how you going to steal it?
That's it. But he can kill your joy. Mm-hmm. He could kill your faith and steal your joy and then utterly destroy you.
Mm-hmm.
So, but at any rate, we're going to end right there. We love you guys today. Thank you all so much for tuning in. Sis, we love you so much. She says she loves us two ladies together.
We love you too.
So we love you guys today. Thank you so much for tuning in. Until next week, same time, same station.
Just want to say a quick thing because some people came in late. We do have a page, and it's Let's Talk For Real page. It's open to the public, so you can always go back and look at any of the videos so you won't have to search the feed and search my page and search her page. Yes. We upload all the videos to that particular page, and it's open to the public.
Yeah.
You're welcome to add your comments, any topics you want us to talk about, any feedback you want to give us. You can rate us on that page.
Yeah, so, and like us.
Yeah, like us, share. And we do every Friday at 5:30. Like she said, we try to keep it to at least 30 minutes because we don't want to overextend, you know, your attention span because we know that you're just getting off work and everything. Yeah. But we're excited for those that are here on a regular basis.
Yes,
and
we love you guys for joining. We appreciate you so much for that.
So and we're looking forward to what God is going to do with Let's Talk For Real.
Yeah.
So let's talk.
Let's talk for real, let's talk. Let's talk for real, let's talk. Let's talk for real, let's talk for real. Have a blessed week.